Bonjour, namaste and hello. Brown and Strong in Africa is back with another exciting driving video. And guess what? Today we are driving to the Middle East of the country, Cote d'Ivoire, and we are going to explore a village called Amelikia, which is not far from the town called Abengourou. So that's why my little one is pretty much excited. All set, and let's start with today's video. Around 5 to 6 hours journey from Abidjan, and we take the Yopougon road to go to this town. So let me explain you what all town we will be crossing to reach to this village called Amelikia. So whenever you are going to these places, it's preferable that you always turn on your Google map and follow the Google map route, as it will guide you the fastest and you will be able to reach there without any diversions. So there are two routes to go to Abengourou. One is via A1 and second is via A4. The first one has 3 to 4 tolls that you will have to cross, but the second one, which is via A4, is the longest route, but there are no tolls. So we went through via A1 route, which is having at least 2 to 3 toll gates in between that you will have to pass, and it is around 205 kilometers, and we took around 6 hours to reach there because we stopped multiple times in between. But if you're not stopping and you are just going there non-stop without any halt in between, then you should be able to reach there exactly by 4 hours and 10 minutes. So the forest that you're seeing next to me is at Yopougon Road, and this is called as Banco National Forest. It is extremely huge and big, and people come here to just explore the nature and eat something together, to run or just to exercise. There are many people who are coming here just to explore this forest. I've never went inside, but I heard there are some animals as well in the forest. So the main towns that you will pass through while going to Abengourou is Yakase, Agbau, Akupe, and then you reach to Abengourou. In between there will be very very small towns that you will be crossing as well, but the main towns are these that you will be crossing to reach to Abengourou. And then from Abengourou to reach to this village called Amelikia, it takes around 25 to 35 minutes. I think even more than that, because the roads are not really good. So it's all sand, so it took us around 45 minutes drive to reach to the village. So one thing you will notice, that there are a lot of farms when you cross these towns: banana, rubber, pineapple, peanuts, all kind of vegetables. Everything is grown in these farms because the lands are huge and people have taken these lands to really do the plantation. And whatever the season is, you will see people are plucking it from there and then just selling it. So the fruits or the vegetables that you really buy from there are the vegetables which are fresh and directly coming from the farms. So the local people who are living in Abidjan to work, they have their families up country and they prefer to travel there every month to see their family, and they take this opportunity to just buy all the vegetables, fruits, and whatever the season is, just buy many things and then come back home, because first thing it is extremely cheap and the second thing is extremely fresh, directly coming from the farm. So this is what I have observed, and we do the same way. Whenever we get the chance to travel up country, we prefer to buy many vegetables and fruits to come back, and the taste is really different from what we get in these supermarkets here. So this village that we are going to is a village of Akan people. So mostly the people who are living there are from the ethnic group of Cote d'Ivoire, which is Akan. So let me tell you few things about this ethnic group, which is quite interesting. So the Aka people are primarily in the countries of present-day Ghana and Ivory Coast. But Aka culture can also be found in the Americas, where a number of their descendants were taken as captives. Roughly 10% of all slave ships that embarked from the coast of West Africa contained Aka people. Although gold was the primary source of wealth in their economy, the capture and sale of Aka people peaked during the Fante and Ashanti conflicts, resulting in a high number of military captives known as Koromanti being sold into slavery. Koromanti soldiers and other Aka captives were known for various slave revolts and plantations resistance tactics. Their legacy is evident within groups such as Maroons of the Caribbean and South America. Aka people are believed to have migrated to their current location from the Sahara Desert and Sahel regions of Africa into the forest region around the 11th century. Many Aka tell their history as it started in the eastern region of Africa, as this is where the ethnogenesis of Aka as we know them today happened. Aka culture is considered as one of the traditional cultures of Africa. Aka art is wide-ranging and renowned, especially for the tradition of crafting bronze gold weights using the lost wax casting method. Speaking about the ethnic group Aka, it also reminds me of speaking about the Queen Puku, who was the queen and founder of the Baule ethnic group in West Africa. She ruled over a branch of the powerful Ashanti Empire as it expanded westward. Puku was born Princess of Kumasi, Ghana. She became the leader of a breakaway group from the main Ashanti Confederacy, which she refused to join. Disagreements among the factions resulted in war. Legend says that she had to sacrifice her only son for the people to cross river. After crossing the river, Puku and her people settled into an agricultural way of life in the savannah of the area. Queen Puku died shortly after creating the Baule Kingdom. Her niece Akwaboni succeeded to the throne. She pursued wars of conquest to widen the limits of the Yuan Kingdom. The Baule people today inhabit the territory between the Kumue and Bandama rivers. They make up around 15% of the country's population, having assimilated some smaller tribes over the centuries. The founding legend of the Baule people holds that when Puku and her people arrived at the Kumue River, it was uncrossable. Puku asked her priest for the counsel, and he told her to sacrifice of a noble child was required to cross the river. Puku then sacrificed her son, throwing the infant into the water. Legend has it that after the sacrifice, hippopotami appeared and formed a bridge which Puku and her people used to cross to the opposite bank of the Kumue. Once on the other side, she called out Bauli, or the child is dead. This is why her descendants today are known as the Bauli. Crossed the city and reached to the towns and crossed various towns to reach to Amilikya. We saw the people were relaxed, there was almost zero traffic and the weather was not as hot as Abidjan, and it was so calm, peaceful, full of greenery, and it was extremely beautiful. It was also very interesting to see what people are wearing, what people are eating, how people are living inside the villages or inside the towns of the country. We only see the major part of the country in Abidjan and Yamoussoukro, but there are many other people or many other towns which exist in the country, which is really interesting to see. Being said all this, some things are still similar all around the world. Back in India, we have auto, which is similar to the small vehicle which is just going in front of me, which can accommodate 4 to 5 people, and it is a means of transportation in small towns. And coming back to Africa, I saw the same auto, which they call it as Saloni. It was so funny to see an auto in Africa. As we are reaching to the town Abenguru. Abenguru is a city in eastern Cote d'Ivoire. It is the seat of both Kumue district and Indenye Juabling region. It is also a commune and the seat of a sub-prefecture of Abenguru department. Abenguru is primarily populated by the Ani ethnic group, a branch of the Akha people who migrated to the region from Ghana. In the 2014 census, the population of Abengourou was 135,635. The city is served by the Abengourou Airport. There is also the interior's largest hospital. There is an agricultural vocational training institute along with a research station that specializes in the local crops of cocoa and coffee. These crops are then transported the 151 kilometers to Abidjan for export. Within the city is the residence of Anyi Paramount Chief, who is also the king of Indenye. His home was built in 1882 and is decorated with artifacts. The name Abengourou stems from the Akan language expression Pekro, which means I don't like long discussions. Coming to Amilikya, where we are actually heading to, it's a town in eastern Ivory Coast. It is a sub-prefecture of Abengourou department as well. Amilikya was a commune until March 2012, when it became one of 1,126 communes nationwide that were abolished. The government of the Ivory Coast or Côte d'Ivoire is trying to merge different municipalities and communes in their attempt to increase urbanization. From this specific point, we did not see any roads further. It was all sand, red sand, and the village of Amilikya actually starts from here. So you go deep inside, there's a long drive of around 30 to 45 minutes, and then we reach to the place where we wanted to go. So just enjoy this beautiful village ride of Côte d'Ivoire to the village called Amilikya. It is so beautiful and so natural. We really enjoyed our stay here. I will continue to show you how we spent our one night in Amilikya and what we ate and how the people of Amilikya and the kids of Amilikya welcomed us. I will be uploading that video soon as well. I'm working on it. Till then, just enjoy the beautiful village ride and see how beautiful the village is. I hope you get to learn a lot about Akka ethnic group and the different towns of Côte d'Ivoire. I will be seeing you guys very soon with my next video, which will be about this village, Amelikia. I hope this video was useful. If yes, please do not forget to subscribe to my channel. Also hit the like button and also share this video with the people who are traveling to Côte d'Ivoire so that they can learn more about the country. Till then, take care. Bye-bye.